And what can you say? I mean, honest to God, what can you possibly say about the match we just witnessed? For, I mean, the Dusty Rhodes Classic. That match. Wow. That, I mean, I am not, I mean, I know who Jackson Ryker is from his time in Impact Wrestling. I know who Wesley Blake is, but I'm not super familiar with Cutler. But these teams, holy shit. This was possibly the most amazing match I think I've seen in forever. This, I mean, it's not by, I mean, I am at a loss for words right now. I truly am. I am truly at a loss for words. This is just, holy shit. This was awesome. It was an awesome freaking ending. That was a fantastic main event. It really was. And hats off to all four of those guys. To Cutler, to Wesley Blake, to Ricochet, to Black. Hats off, and I applaud you. I really, really do. I do. I applaud you guys. This was a really good episode of NXT television. I think it's a good last episode before TakeOver. I understand next week is still another episode, but next week will mainly be recaps going into TakeOver on Friday, so it won't be it won't be your normal episode. But nonetheless, it was a really good episode. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed tonight's episode. I enjoyed that main event. It was really good. And I got a lot more out of the Forgotten Sons than I think I would have. They did just way, way better than I could have even imagined they would have done. Realistically. But it was good. Good main event. Fantastic opening segment tonight with Johnny Gargano and Adam Cole cutting some promos on each other, talking about their paths to this NXT Championship match at TakeOver New York. It was a beautiful main event, or a beautiful opening, a really awesome show. I'm excited. Let's talk about this thing. Let's get into it. This is your TakeOver review, guys. Let's go ahead and hit that little intro. Welcome in, Yo Bro Nation, to your NXT review for March 27, 2019. I am Zach. I am here. I am leading the charge again tonight for your NXT review. Obviously, I did something a little different. I'm going to keep doing this going forward until someone tells me it's stupid. But I'll do these little cold opens. I'll just kind of talk a little bit about the show. Honest to God, I don't know what to say about that main event. That was, honest to God, a beautifully done match. It really was. It was a much better match than I think I really needed to be. And that is not me blowing smoke up anyone's ass just to have a quote at the end of the show. It really was that good. I mean, honest to God. Yeah, the welcome back into the channel, guys. I'm Zach. I'm the man around here on this channel, this very small channel. I'm gonna keep doing these openings like this, I think, going forward. You know, this was running so smooth earlier. Now the lag is so bad again. I had to do some recordings today, and this was super good earlier, but NXT, man. We're on the road to take over New York. Off top. I did not get to do my SmackDown live review last night. I opted to go with my girlfriend to her son's concert for his band, so I went with that. And by the time we got home, SmackDown was over, and I had forgot to record it anyways. So, no SmackDown review this week. I did go back and did look at the clips and did listen to other reviews. Charlotte Flair, man. Charlotte Flair becoming the women's champion. I was shocked. Shocked at first. I mean, I didn't see that coming. I mean, honest to God, I didn't see that coming. I have theories on, I think, what they're doing. I think there's a slim chance that Asuka's going to be added. Slim to none. But I hear, like, JD from New York saying it might be a unification match. Others saying that they don't think it's going to be, and I think I agree with them. I don't think this is going to be a unification match. I think Charlotte's just going to be in the main event. Kofi Kingston's finally getting his WWE title match after another gauntlet. Although what the Usos did during that gauntlet match was pretty nice. But a gauntlet match again when they should have ended that, you know, last week. I don't know. But SmackDown, I think, overall was probably a pretty good episode. Like I said, I didn't get to watch it, so therefore I didn't review it. But it looked like it was going to be pretty good. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and get all the little promos out. Friday is going to be a channel update, letting you guys know some stuff going on with the channel, some changes to some of the programming, just stuff for my sanity, basically. Also, my final Best of the Best WrestleMania countdown will be on Sunday. Retro Rewind will be on Saturday. Yo Bro Nation coming up this week, episode 7 this week. Going to be a lot of topics to cover in that as well. But let's go ahead and let's get into our social media plugs. Why don't we? Patreon.com/YoBroNation. You guys can become a member of the Yo Bro Nation. Become a Patreon member. There's 6 tiers to choose from. You guys can go check that stuff out yourself. It's totally optional. But you guys get little things like Q&As, AEW reviews, Monday Morning Creative, which is a little podcast that I do on there. I might make that something for people. I don't know. I might release that actually on the channel. I'm not sure. Classic Raw reviews, post-show videos, which I'll have one for WrestleMania, maybe TakeOver. Lots more stuff to come. Like I said, I kind of teased you guys with a little bit. I said too much, but yeah. There's other options, though, if you guys aren't exactly dying to do the Patreon thing. There is other options that you guys can explore. You guys can simply go to teepublic.com/YoBroNation1. Would love for you guys to join our TeePublic store. All these shirts, I'm wearing one of them now, the classic YoBro Gaming Review shirt. I just absolutely love this. Got the YoBro WrestleMania t-shirts, YoBro Manias 1 and 1.5, Best of the Best Countdown, YoBro Nation Queen Inspired shirt, the Veteran shirt, Recess Never Gets Old, Charlotte Reigns, freaking Kissing Bandit, more shirts. There's also hats. We have like bags and cups and mugs and other things on there, posters, all that stuff on the store. You guys can go and check that out. If maybe that's something you're also not really into, you're not really looking to do, you guys can simply go to our social media, YoBroGaming1 on Twitter and YoBro Nation on Facebook. You guys can like and follow our stuff on there. Follow us on social media. Twitter's the best way you guys will be able to keep up to date with things, since YouTube isn't always on the ball with everything. You guys can also like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Like the videos, share them with your friends, and then both of you guys, or gals, subscribe to the channel. So let's go ahead and let's get into this review. Like I said, this is your NXT review for March 27th of 2019. A very, very good episode. But it did kick off with Adam Cole. Adam Cole comes out, says that he's got a million reasons why he can beat Johnny Gargano at TakeOver New York and walk out as the NXT champion. He says he's going to get into those. But first, he needs Johnny Gargano to come out. Johnny does oblige. And, well, here's what Johnny had to say.
My path to the NXT championship goes through you. I'm going to show you why. They call me Johnny TakeOver, baby!
This was after Johnny TakeOver, Adam Cole.
Johnny, is that supposed to scare me? Because listen, Johnny, I don't know if your memory has been shot, but you haven't necessarily been in the old winner's circle when it comes to TakeOver. I think maybe it'd be more appropriate if it was maybe Johnny Participation.
That's kind of.
And the fact is, Johnny Participation cannot beat Adam Cole 2 out of 3 falls. And here's why. I became the first ever NXT North American champion at TakeOver. The first ever War Games match in WWE history. I won and I did it at TakeOver. My debut here in NXT, I beat down Drew McIntyre, held the NXT championship high above my head in the Barclays Center, and I did it at TakeOver. So how fitting is it that we return to the Barclays Center for me to reach the pinnacle of my NXT career by becoming NXT champion and beating you in the process?
Oh, it's gorgeous.
What has Johnny TakeOver done to earn this championship match at TakeOver New York?
Let me remind you what I went through just to get here, okay? They didn't roll out the red carpet for me like they did for you. I didn't get the debut in front of 15,000 people in New York and get a top spot immediately in NXT. No, my story started June 2015 at my tryout where I was told no. But you know what? I didn't take no for an answer. Okay? I fought for one chance, and that chance came at the first ever Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic.
I fought so hard that they
chanted Johnny Wrestling. I fight for everyone out there who's ever been told no. I fight for everyone who's ever been told that their dream will not come true. I fought and I earned everything I have because this place is my life. I will fight to fulfill my destiny. And Johnny Wrestling will finally become NXT champion.
And after that, I mean, there was more to it, but it was such a fantastic way to start the show. It really was. These two guys were, oh my God, I can't wait to see this match. I can't wait to see it. I think this is going to be, it's going to be that match. I really think that it's going to... Oh, wait, where'd I go? Oh, there I am. Ooh, look, I'm like a speedster. Ooh, I'm the Flash. I'm just checking to see. Oh, well. So, yeah, I can't wait to see this. 2 out of 3 falls at NXT TakeOver. Can it be next Friday? I mean, really, can we be to next Friday when this show is going on? Can I please get to the show and just see this? It's going to be glorious, I guess. I don't know. But TakeOver, in just a little more than a week, I can't wait. And this card is stacking up. So, now that I got all that other stuff ready. So, they showed us what happened with the Forgotten Sons and how they attacked Black and Ricochet last week at the end of the show. Then we get a match between Vanessa Bourne and Aaliyah versus Lacey Lane and Casey Catanzaro, who, very impressive. Very, very impressive. I unfortunately, though, didn't get to see quite a bit of this match because my internet froze up. So I caught the end of it after their introductions. So whatever happened, I apologize. I have to go back and rewatch it, but I did miss a good chunk of this match. Not that I think there was a lot anyway. Gotta love your stuff, man. Why can't my stuff just work? I don't know why. So yeah, I know that, you know, Vanessa Bourne and Aaliyah were in control, wearing down Lacey Lane, but then out came Shayna Baszler, Marina Shafir, and Jessamyn Duke. Three women out of the four horsewomen of the MMA. Baszler gets in there, kneed Lacey Lane right in the face. They tossed Catanzaro out of the ring. Catanzaro, though, gets back in the ring. Baszler tries putting her in the Carafuta clutch. I'll get it right one day. Puts her in the Carafuta clutch. She fought back, though. She gets away. She, you know, gets away from Duke, gets away from Shafir. But then ends up right inside that move, and she's just choked out. Baszler walks up to the announce table, yells at them, "This is going to continue to happen as long as the champion of this company is disrespected." And then she gets on the table, and she celebrates. She's feeling disrespected because she's got that fatal four-way coming up at TakeOver. So this must be her, I guess, lobbying for the match to be... taken off the books, but it's not going to, and I can't wait to see it either. You can call me whatever you want, but I absolutely cannot wait for this pay-per-view. Oh my god. TakeOver, it's gonna be so good. So good. And it'll be a simple 2.5, maybe 3-hour show, and I can't wait. I honestly cannot wait. Oh man. So then they went over, and then they announced all the matches that are currently going on. Of course, we're going to have Gargano versus Adam Cole. We're going to have, holy crap, my brain just went dead. It's dead. They announced the matches. Of course, they also announced the Fatal 4-Way. They also announced Matt Riddle taking on the Velveteen Dream. Oh, and they announced the UK Championship being defended with Pete Dunne and Walter. I have never got to see Walter wrestle outside of the clips I've seen on YouTube. I know he's got that real nasty chop. Oh my god, I can't wait to see that. But then we get Matt Riddle versus Kona Reeves. Not impressed by this dude at all. He does not impress me. Matt Riddle does, but he does not. And he made Matt Riddle look a little slow in this match. But he slaps Matt Riddle. Riddle gets angry, though, right? And Riddle's pretty much like, bro. But he slaps Riddle. Riddle gets mad, so Reeves tries to take advantage of that. Riddle, though, does fight back. Hits a side suplex on Reeves, but then out comes the Velveteen Dream. Out on a couch with women carrying him out and giving him a cup full of stuff. Reeves tries to take advantage, but Riddle, you know, gets a reversal, tries to go for a German, but Kona gets him in the Kona sleeper. Riddle, though, comes back, gets a bunch of strikes in, hits that ripcord knee, starts just laying in the elbows on Kona Reeves, and then gets him the bro mission, and he almost taps out immediately. Dream calls, you know, says, cuts off the, you know, you're winner, and going on to face me, your Velveteen Dream, Matthew Riddle. And Riddle goes up there, grabs his cup, drinks out of it, throws it, and then says, "I'll see you at New York, bro," and walks off. I ain't gonna lie, I was a little iffy on Matt Riddle when he first came in, but I'm telling you now, dude is fucking top notch. And again, Velveteen Dream, there's no way this match isn't gonna be a 4-star match. Just no way. These two going for the North American Championship. I am so pumped for this show. You guys have no idea how pumped I am for these shows. They're going to be awesome. I have no doubt these are going to be awesome show. This is going to be an awesome show. But we do know next week, Kairi Sane going to be taking on Bianca Belair one-on-one. Will probably be a good match. It might be the only match I think we see next week. I'll probably still do the NXT review, but like I said, it's going to be just mainly a recap episode. So that will be a very short episode next week when I do this. But then we get the main event. The Dusty Rhodes Classic Finals. Forgotten Sons versus Aleister Black and Ricochet. I was not expecting the match that I got. I said that at the beginning. I still mean it. I was not expecting the match that I got. It was awesome. It really was. All four men, though, brawled to start the match. Blake and Black, they started it off going one-on-one. You get some more fighting with all four guys. Black and Ricochet, you know, did their little pose. You had Blake and Cutler standing in front of them just like... The crowd ate this up tonight. The crowd at Full Sail ate this up. You can tell this is the beginning of the tapings because they're, you know, full of energy. Then they just start kind of flying around the ring. You got a moonsault off the middle apron to the middle rope to the outside by Ricochet. And then the Meteora double knees by Aleister Black to the outside. Cutler gets thrown in. He rolls right back out, trying to stay away from Ricochet. Ricochet goes after him, knees him. They get back into the ring, but they end up getting the advantage. Ricochet's battling both men. They get the advantage. Blake is in control. Him and Cutler are tagging in and out. They're kind of working over the back of Ricochet throughout this match. Ricochet tries fighting back, hits some elbows, hits a drop kick. Blake tries to stop him. He gets thrown out of the ring, but then he pulls Aleister Black down, so he chases him. They continue to try to cut the ring off, but Ricochet shimmies his way across, gets the tag. Aleister Black comes in there, house on fire, hitting some strong strikes on both men. Let's see, where am I? Hits a moonsault on Cutler. Attempts to go for the Black Mask, but that gets broke up by Blake. Cutler hits him with a backbreaker. Ricochet leaps over Blake. They're in the corner. This was really cool. They're in the corner, and Ricochet jumps over. I think he was... Blake and Black into the corner. He jumps over them. Hurricanrana onto Cutler. He rolls out of the ring. But then a clothesline on Ricochet by Blake. Then the Meteora by Black onto Blake. Blake, you know, Wesley Blake and Ricochet, they're fighting. They're getting some exchanges of uppercuts. Then they try suplexing each other, and one gets him up. Oh, no. Then the other one gets him up. No. And finally, after several attempts, Ricochet is able to get him up into a twisting suplex, almost like a brain buster. The fighting keeps going. Blake does a reverse Frankensteiner off the top rope to Ricochet, but Ricochet lands on his feet, stares him down. Blake finally turns around and is like, and he ends up getting hit. We get a GTS. I'm thinking it was a GTS. It followed by a big boot. Blake gets covered only for a 2 count. Like this match, I'm just telling you what happened. It's hard. Go watch this. Watch NXT later. An O'Connor roll for only a 2 count by Wesley Blake. He was in the majority of this match. So, Blake, though, hits a backstabber, followed by the elbow off the top by Cutler. You get a 2 count. Blake hits his double knee finisher, his double knee gut buster. gets a two count. You get a black mask by Aleister Black onto Cutler. Riker gets kicked out of the ring because he comes over to the ropes and ends up getting kicked out of the match. A little bit of chaos happens, but then you get a black mask. Then Black runs, jumps over the rope, then does a moonsault to the outside. You get a 630 by Ricochet for the three count. Ricochet and Aleister Black are now heading to NXT TakeOver New York to face the War Raiders for the championships. The War Raiders actually come out to the ring, and they're face-to-face, and there's just some trash-talking. Nice, friendly trash-talk. Nice visual to close the show with these two teams face-to-face with that trophy right in the middle. Interesting that they won. Honest to God, interesting that they won, because it's looking as if they're also going to be on the WrestleMania card competing for the Raw Tag Team title. So there is the very slim chance that these guys could walk out with both the NXT titles and the Raw titles. However, at the same time, there's a chance they could walk out with neither championship. Now, I'm more prone to say they walk out with the Raw titles versus walking out with the other ones because, well, they are leaving NXT. I'm sure they're going full-time after this. After WrestleMania, I'm sure that they will be full-time guys. So where does that leave them? I think War Raiders are going to retain, but I'll give my official prediction on the preview and predictions next Thursday. Instead, usually I do them on a Friday or a Saturday, depending on what's the takeover. Next week will be on Thursday. So, we'll have to wait. We'll have to see what happens. It's going to be an awesome match. I'm almost positive it will be. So, I think WrestleMania Weekend's TakeOver is going to be one hell of a flipping show. That is going to do it for me. I want to thank everybody for coming in and joining me on this NXT. I don't care if it's 200 or 20 or 200. I don't care. Thank you, guys. I'm cool with my small numbers. I really am. I would love to grow just for all people to see it. So NXT TakeOver. New York, it's going to be awesome. This was an awesome show. Fantastic show. So, again, thank you, everybody, for coming in and joining me for this review. I am Zach. Remember, y'all can go to my Twitter and my Facebook. Twitter at YoBroGame1. Facebook at YoBroNation. You guys can go there and follow us, like us, like, share, subscribe to my channel, tell your friends about us. This was your NXT review. I hope you guys liked the intro. I apologize for the lag. I am working on it. You guys think I need to just do a podcast? You guys let me know. Again, I'm Zach. I will talk to you all later on. I'll see you guys.